I have boogers up my nose. You can see it. Why have I always got boogers up my nose? Do you know, like, if you have a runny nose, it means in a crying?
Really?
Yeah. If you have a cough, it means you're barking at people because you can't vocalize what you're saying. If you lose your voice, you've given up trying to speak your mind and your thoughts. It's amazing. And when you think about it, you go, oh wow, that's why I lost my voice and shit. And you know, and you can pinpoint exactly what it is that upset you to make you that physical illness. It's amazing. No wonder why you put the animals there.
Well, we actually... So, the reason why we put the animals there was because I didn't want that room because it's directly onto the street and we had to, like, next to school, and I was just going to be anxious all the time about it.
Yep. Even though I was concentrating on the cards and concentrating on what I was going to read for my client, I found that listening in hindsight, I get to hear the conversation again that my daughter and I talked about. There's been a lot of times because of my head injuries that I have unable to recollect direct conversations. So this is a very important time to me because I got to spend time with my precious jewel and love her forever by her stupid ways of caring about me. And why I call it stupid, because I feel like I'm stupid. I love you, Ruby. I love you, Harley. And thank God you are mine.
And I'll just set up just to do the shuffling of the deck.
With this new tarot deck that I have a new fire in my stomach, not only to create my own deck, but to play with this one. I have chosen the name for it. And the name that I've chosen for this beautiful deck will be announced soon. Some paranormal activity and some ghostly spooks. Not only that, a cat. Listen to the sounds in the background and you'll be amazed at how much I liken it to the paranormal activity around my house. I have this growling entity around me who sometimes checks on me in my room. I don't know how, but I think he actually uses the vision and satellites. But anyway, long story short, please listen to the background and know that this is while on slow motion, and I do admit it is on slow motion. Not many people can record some of what you can hear on my paranormal series. There's the putty cat, there's the putty cat. No, I'm not Tweety. I'm not a bird. I'm just Cindy Isabel Schulter, Jolly Hunter Ash, entertaining you, and just listen and watch and you'll be amazed. if you watch carefully, just after the cat video and I turn and beam to the left, you'll see a face of an old man or an old woman there, and you have to try to pause it on it because it's only there for a second, and it's really, really trippy because the face is clear as. So just keep watching and look for the space on the left hand corner to about halfway up, bottom left hand corner to about halfway up. It's coming up soon, guys. I'm not kidding you about those faces, and I'm not kidding you about my monstrous entity that hangs around me or sees me through satellite vision. If you don't believe me, keep watching. I think my beast likes the putty cat. Right there, can you see it? It's just in the left-hand corner. There it is, right on the top. Can you see the face? It's also
yeah, so
now watch closely. Isaiah's provided much entertainment that weekend. So we turn it up. Yeah, we turn it up. Ain't got no tears in my body. On my journey to Geelong, I did a bit of sightseeing while I was waiting for my daughter and her boyfriend to come back from the real estate agent because they had just fucking got a house, and I'm telling you, it was hectic and we still got more dramas. But these are the sightseeings that I had while I was just waiting for them in the hot summer of Australia. Be blessed. I don't know what my daughter and her boyfriend, Ray, were doing in the bathroom. I think they were in the shower, and it sounds really peculiar. So I thought I'd talk over and say, I'm in love with this deck. Go to www.thelgoliathtarotdeck.com and buy this deck or share his product and just basically get the word out. Wow, just in time for Christmas, I have some fantastic news. After all the house hunting, after all the stress, my daughter has finally found housing, and we are so grateful to the landlords, the real estate And basically, anyone who's involved and contributed, like my dad, Bronwyn, myself, Raymond, and especially Ruby for pointlessly doing all those applications and all the stress she has been under lately. I have been mourning for my daughter. I hope to help her as a burden somewhat, but it's been great news and we are so relieved. And we have a bit of extra time with staying here too to clean up and get things out. So it'll be busy times and I'll film as much as I can. But now I'm back to the shop. I just want to say thank you. Leaving to find my soul. Then you're gonna get hip hop versions of Merry Christmas and all the rest. And I know it ain't pretty when our hearts get broke. Too young to feel this old. Watching us both turn cold. Oh, I know it ain't pretty when two hearts get broke. Yeah, I know it ain't pretty when two hearts get broke. I hope someday we'll sit down together and laugh with each other about these days all our troubles we'll lay to rest and we'll wish we could come back to these days.
Look how cute your puppy is.
Puppy?
Look at me, look at you.
Puppy? Puppy.
Why are we surrounding Mom?
I'm getting scared. There's too many dogs. There's too many dogs in here. There's too many... Sarah's definitely giving up.
Simple things, please. Simple minds.
Got plenty of them. Oh, Artie was going, Mom, where are you, Mom? Before.
But then again, those simple minds could get up to some pretty good creativity, don't you think? Think about everything we've been creating lately, Ruby. Please go to my social media and comment whether you would be interested in getting a free reading. Limited time only.
These days. 3 years of ups and downs, nothing to show for it now. And I know it ain't pretty when when the fire burns out, calling me when I'm drunk.